out in the streets. And if rock has its song say, they just can't be. Muggers and robbers, don't they seem to be safe? When you've been my protection, there is never a way. I must say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah. It could have been me. Yeah.
I am so excited.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Yes. Amen.
Oh, I'm excited about mom. I'm just excited about God and the things of God and what He's done and what He's about to do.
Yes.
When Sister Tanisha called and asked me to bring the word for today, I got excited, especially when she was talking about a homecoming service.
Yes.
And that meant that all of the people that were part of the ministry, now I was a part of the ministry since I was 8 years old. And I want to honor somebody. I want to honor our Pastor Pearson. And I put Pastor Pearson. I apologize to that. And before I go on in the word, there's a lot of friends of mine that I personally invited. My good friend Bishop. If I call everybody's name, somebody's gonna think, you didn't call me.
Right.
But a couple of my friends drove over 2 hours, or just about 2 hours to get here. As Bishop Stephen Mitchell and his friend, I want you to stand, Bishop. And also my good friend, Brother Jeremiah James, he drove a good distance to be here. You can wave your hand.
Amen.
I have several co-workers. You know when you can get your co-workers and your family to come and hear you minister, that's saying something. I want all of my co-workers to stand, even if it's DHS, Temple, wherever. I want you guys to stand. And all of the ministers that I invited, I want you to stand. My mother, is here. My mother is 97 years old. Raise your hand, mother. Mother is 97 years old. And she was here. Mother was here when I preached my initial message at, I think I was 16 years old. And she, my mother, myself, and my grandma, we just danced all over the church. Everybody was just saying, oh, isn't that wonderful? But I tell you, I thank God for my mother, my sister, my brother Rob, my sister Julia, all my family. Please say that, my children, y'all. My children. Aisha told me, she said, Mom, we are not two. We're not two no more. You don't have to keep talking about us like that, Mom. We're not two no more. So I have to remember, they're not two. Not until they want something. I would that you all pray for me. Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus. Just to take Him at His word. Just to rest. Upon His promise, just to know the saying, the Lord Jesus. just love him. I love him. I love him.
Yeah.
Jesus, Jesus.
I pray.
Precious Jesus. Regardless of what you got to go through, isn't that joy? when you came to know Jesus. But I tell you, if I didn't get it when I got it, I don't know where I would be. I'm glad I got it when they was calling on Jesus. I'm glad they were spitting all in your face. I'm glad I got it back then. Because some of this stuff that folk going to school now, y'all, they paying $39.99 to learn how to speak in tongues. They paying $49.99 to get a license.
That's right.
Everybody want to be a pastor. Everybody want to be an apostle. Everybody want to be a bishop. $39.99. Y'all can have it. I tell you, because I used to say some time ago, I was a pastor. Yep, I was called the pastor. I need to pastor these members right up in here. And then I was responsible for pastoring my children. And being an example to my children. In case y'all don't know, it does start at home. And then spreads abroad. In Genesis,
all right, sweetie,
the 28th chapter.
All right.
Most of these I'm going to want you to read when you get home. Genesis, the 28th chapter. Habakkuk, the second chapter. And then Romans, the 12th chapter. Life now is sweet, and my joy is complete. Chapter, and we're going to begin reading at the 13th verse. And behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac, the land on which you live. You lie, I will give you and your descendants.
Yes, yes.
Also, your descendants shall be as the dust of the earth. You shall spread abroad to the west and to the east, the north and the south. And in you and in your seed, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. Behold, I am with you and will keep you wherever you go and will bring you back to this land. For I will not leave you until I have done what I have spoken to you. Chosen for a thought to leave with you this evening. Holiness is still right. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, holiness is still right. This particular scripture reminds me of the leaders that we are honoring today, but especially my pastor, the late Rosie Wallace Brown. I liken this scripture to them because it just shows when you at a certain place in God, when you have a consecration on your life, God will speak to you in order for you to speak to his people.
Right. Amen.
A lot of us say that we have gifts and callings, and that's all good, but your leader will have to sanction those callings and those giftings.
Oh my God.
You cannot think that you're so above your leaders where you won't listen to your leaders and try to take the position that God has ordained for them to be in. Now there's only one pastor. When I was coming up, there was only one pastor. However, everybody was trying to tell her how to do what God ordained her to do. As they lay before God, and here Isaac had a dream, and he was in this dream he saw a big ladder. And on top of this ladder, the angels were all around him and were ministering to him and telling him what to give to people. Now, if we pay attention, instead of trying to take over and thinking that we have arrived because we had maybe one or two engagements, now we want to be the right reverend leader instead of taking counsel and taking wisdom and getting direction from our leaders. I preached my initial sermon when I was 17 years old. The youngest minister at First Church also to be ordained. I was ordained at, I think I was around 20, 21, something like that. My niece, she's not here today. My niece, Lefer, my sister's oldest daughter, but she and I are 2 years apart. And she said to me, we talked a couple of months ago, and she said to me, "Barbara, I want you to know God is showing up in your life because you are so different. You're just different from the rest of the people that I know and that we went to school with." She said, "You was a mess." I don't remember that. All I know is I was carrying my Bible. I was loving God. You know, I was just trying to be everything that pastor had taught us to be. Back then, we couldn't wear no makeup.
No.
You couldn't wear no braids. You couldn't wear no pants. And I was like, wow, this is something. And even when I got married, Brother Eddie told me, because I couldn't wear makeup. Brother Eddie told me, he said, "Just put Vaseline." "Just put Vaseline on your eyebrows." "And put Vaseline on your eyelashes." When I look back at the few pictures, I look like somebody crazy. What saved was all about, sweet Jesus. But I was so glad when Dad Cleveland came along. Dad Cleveland said to the anointed man of God that he is, he said, "If the building need paint, if the building needs paint, and if you don't know how to do it, my daughter, there you go. The makeup artist that she is, she'll show you how to do it." Praise God. But Jacob was saying, the presence
right.
of the Lord.
Yes.
And can you imagine he's pouring out his heart to God and the angel speaking to him? And so it was with our leaders back then. They wanted us to be somebody.
Yeah.
They wanted us to, if there was a calling on your life,
yes,
I expect to see something yeah. different yeah. in your life. Yeah. Pastor would teach us, some can, but you can't.
Right.
And y'all also know you gotta be a what?
Yeah.
What she say?
A peach out of reach.
You gotta be a peach out of reach. Honey, today, and I remember back then, people would cross the street to reverence the house of God. Now, they smoking, they drinking, crack bars is all over. Nobody respects the house of God anymore. And there was a time when a minister would walk by and you knew by the way, just by the way that they walked and by the way that they entered into a room that they were somebody. We don't even honor God's people anymore. Nobody's caught up into titles, but if they earned it,
yeah.
give it to them.
Amen. Amen.
You're not their best buddy. Why you can how you can disrespect them?
Right.
You honor everybody else. Now, I'm not talking about the ones that paid $39.99. I'm talking about those that have paved the way. I'm talking about those that have sacrificed.
Yeah.
And gave their all.
Yes.
Elder Beverly is one of the ones, and Sister Harriet that I can remember, and Sister Mildred, Brother Walter, some of the ones that was back in the day, and when we were on Diamond Street at the garage before. We was all trying to worship God, and I was running. I was running from 27th Street, from the Baptist Church where I was raised, running from there, trying to get to First Church, and then when you get into the garage before it was all done up,
beautified.
Mm-hmm. We had dust everywhere. Eyelashes. And don't let it be a first Sunday when you had on your white. It was a whole. We were like, oh my God. But it taught us something.
Yeah.
It taught us how to humble ourselves. And then Pastor had such a way about her. She taught us that regardless of where or how high God takes you, you are not all of that. She never as qualified and as gifted as she was.
That's right.
She never made people think that she thought she was all of it. Never. Holiness. Holiness is about living right. Holiness is about having a relationship with God. Holiness is about turning down your plate and instead of relying on your gift, rely on your anointing. The anointing that destroys every yoke. Habakkuk the second chapter. Now if y'all pray for me, I think I can get through this. Y'all praying?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Habakkuk the second chapter. It says, I will stand my watch and set myself on the rampart and watch to see what he will say to me and when I will answer and what I will answer when I am corrected. I will stand upon my watch. I can imagine when our leaders were going to God on our behalf, and they were trying to get us to consecrate yourself, set yourself apart. And the blessings of the Lord was just flowing and flourishing all over the place. And sometimes we get to a place where we think that we have arrived. But God has to remind us of some things.
Yes.
You have to go a little further.
Uh-huh.
You need to study a little harder.
Yeah.
Just because you had one or two preaching engagements, that doesn't make you the right reverend.
Yeah.
I am.
Yeah.
And what another thing that you have to remember is what God has for you is for you.
Uh-huh.
And can't nobody take what God has for you. I don't care how long it takes. I don't care how long you have to persevere. I don't care what you have to face in life. Even if it's 20 years later, what God has for you is for you. The devil wants to rob you of that gift.
Yeah.
A lot of times we have to get a bulldog grip on this thing. We have to let the enemy know that we're just going to take back those things.
Yes.
That he has stole from us.
Yes.
The anointings, our marriages, our ministry.
Yes.
We're just going to take back those things that the enemy has stole from us.
Yeah.
I'm also thinking about the Lion King. Simba. Simba was in line to be the next king. All right. He was in line, and a lot of times we are in line to take over or to be the next leader, but we give up so quick.
Yeah.
We give up too quick.
Yeah.
Well, Simba was set to succeed his father, Mufasa. But Simba's uncle, Scar, he was jealous of Simba and the relationship that he had with his father. Because Scar thought because he was the oldest, he was supposed to be the one to take over the kingdom.
Yes, yes.
Scar made Simba to believe. It just got all out of whack, and then Mufasa, he wanted to protect his son.
Yeah.
He wanted to protect his son. And he made Simba believe that it was his fault while his father was killed. Simba was so upset and he was all the way down in sorrow, felt not my dad. Not my dad. I believe that Simba was a Christian. And when he fled to exile, after being there for some time, the Lord allowed a few good friends to remind him of what he had on the inside. A few, all you need is a few.
That's
right. He had a few good friends to remind him, it's not over, Simba.
Yes.
He had a few good friends to remind him what he was made of.
Yes.
I say he had the Holy Ghost. I don't know what y'all say. His two good friends said, look inside of you, Simba. Look at what you're doing to yourself. Look at how you're giving up on your dad's desire. You know what you're supposed to be doing, Simba. You know what you're supposed to be doing. I believe Simba had such an encounter, and his few good friends They came to him, and I believe one of them or two of them was speaking in tongues. And when they started speaking in tongues, they said, Hakuna Matata. And they had to interpret that. And when they interpreted it, Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase. God, this is
all. It's our problem free.
Yes.
Philosophy. Hakuna Matata.
It's a problem free.
Yeah.
I like that. Listen. You'll get encouraged if you pay attention.
Right.
Why? When he was a young warthog.
Uh-huh.
When I was a young warthog. There he is. Thanks. He found his aroma like a certain appeal. He could play in a savannah and
to get it.
Reveal. I'm a sensitive soul, though I seem thick-skinned. And it hurt that my friends never stood down the wind.
Front
of the kids. Oh, sorry. Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. Ain't no fancy
phrase.
Please don't worry
for the rest of my days. It's a problem.
It's a problem.
It's a problem. Hakuna Matata.
All right. To me, y'all looking at me crazy. But that was an encouragement to me. No words for y'all worry about everything. Instead of y'all say y'all saved, sanctified, and Holy Ghost filled, but you worry about everything. Simba and his friends have to tell you. It's a problem free. Your trust and your everything in Jesus. Maybe you all a little bit too deep for me to get that analogy, but I got it. It's a problem free. Father, I cast all my cares upon you because I know you care for me. Praise God.
We're
worried about everything. Everything is failing. Churches are failing. Homes are failing. Schools are failing. Marriages are failing. Pastors are failing. And Simba had to tell you.
Yes, Simba.
It's a problem free. He had more faith than some of us had.
My God.
I don't get it. We've been in church all of our lives, y'all. And we wait until today to dry up. We wait until today.
Jesus.
I remember when the saints used to just walk to the door and the mothers would be quickening and falling on their faces before God. And I was glad when they said unto me, now folks is all dry. But this is where God wants to restore. He wants to resurrect. God will rejoice and be glad. We do everything else. Let us go to a ball game. Or let us go to a concert. The way that y'all sit here, most of you sit here looking at me, y'all wouldn't do that. No, y'all be running out. Y'all would be having a girl, but when it comes to the house of God, we lost it. We lost it somewhere. We're not excited about our salvation. I remember when I first got saved. I wanted my family to be saved so bad. I got Steve and Sherry, my nieces, and they would help me trying to get the family in. But my brother Rob is here. Wave your hand, Rob. My brother Rob is here, and I used to cry because my brother Thomas used to tease me about being saved. And you know when you first get saved, you're a little bit zealous. And my brother used to ask me, the oldest one used to ask me for scripture. Give me a scripture. No, and I was so crying. And my brother Ralph was like, no, you gotta stand up for what you believe. If you believe it, you gotta stand up for what you believe. You gotta read. So then I started coming to vacation Bible school and I started learning a little bit. But that was when I was like, I was just so excited about being saved, but I ain't know no scripture. But when you know a scripture or two, then you'll be able to, even if it's the same one, God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten son. Just keep on saying that. And then you'll get another one. Then you'll get another one. But let God know that the people, those pioneers that were before us and sacrificed and their mantle. It's on us. And as I began to call different ones, like Evangelist Ann and Minister Freddie and others, Sharon was supposed to be, a lot of them were supposed to be here. And because of what our leaders pour into us, we cannot let it die. We cannot. We're excited and we get excited about the wrong stuff.
Amen.
We get excited about how much money we're gonna raise. But how are you living?
Come on, man.
Woo! Holiness is still right. How are you living?
Amen.
How do you represent Christ?
Yeah. Come on, man.
My God.
When someone see you walking down the street, will they be able to see a difference in your life? You get on some of these jobs and you go to preaching 1 minute, and the next minute you fussing and cussing. They go, what's not wrong with that picture? But how are you living? Holiness is still right. And holiness should be a way of life. Religious people can do anything. You know, they do that. They come to church religiously. But you need to get your whole life turned around. You say God called you. But what are you doing with that calling? You say that God anointed you. But what are you doing with that anointing? Is there a difference in your life? Holiness or hell? In Romans, the 12th chapter, it says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies, every member, a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Since I wouldn't be lost in the house, I wouldn't sit here and just shake my head.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. And another thing we all have to pay attention to, we have our separate gifts, our individual giftings. We're not all alike.
Right.
But the Holy Ghost is one person.
Yeah.
You have to love, you have to forget those things which are behind, and you have to learn how to love people.
Yes.
We don't love God's people the way that we should. We'll talk about them when they messed up. But we don't love God's people the way that we should. Holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Stand on your feet, everyone.